All right, here we are, the 7-7 concept guide, where we're going to transform formulas. I'm outside, it's a beautiful spring day, and there's a lot of pollen out here, so if that affects your allergies, I just want to apologize to you right away. Hopefully, you'll be able to power through. So here's the deal. Sometimes when you have a formula, you might have multiple variables in it, and you might want to solve for the variables that's not in the original formula. To do this, we do exactly all the things we've been doing. I'm not going to read that for you. You've heard this list plenty of times. So here's an example. Here's the formula for the perimeter of a rectangle. P, capital P, perimeter, equals 2 times L plus 2W. What does L and W stand for, do you think? That's the length and the width. The perimeter equals 2 times the length plus 2 times the width. All right, so what if you want to change the formula around to have a new formula for W? It's just like a more familiar equation like this, where it says 10 equals 6 plus 2n. So check this out. How do we solve for 2n? Well, I would subtract 6 from both sides, right? It's furthest away from n. So then I'd get 10 minus 6 equals 2n. Humor me for just a second. Don't turn the 10 minus 6 into 4. Just leave it like that. What do we do next to get n by itself? It's being multiplied by 2, so we need to divide by 2. So the 2's over here will cancel out. And I'm left with 10 minus 6 divided by 2 equals n. Now that looks weird, because you're like, why don't I subtract 10 minus 6? Well, I will. Yeah, that's equal to 4 over 2 equals 2. Yes, that's true. But I want to do that to have a model for what it's going to look like over here. Because check this out. If I'm going to solve for W right over here, what's being done to W? Well, it's being multiplied by 2, and then 2L, 2 times the length, is being added to it. So I'm going to subtract 2L from both sides, just like over here I subtracted 6 from both sides. It's the same mechanics. And so what do I get? It's P minus 2L equals 2W. I can subtract 6 from 10 and get 4, but can you subtract 2L from P? Well, you can, but you can't simplify it. It's just P minus 2L. That's as simplified as that expression gets. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 2, just like I did over on the other side. And what do I end up with? When those guys cancel out, I end up with P minus 2L divided by 2. That's the end. We are done. You might ask, can I do this? Can I cancel out those 2's? Well, over here, could I cancel out the 2? I didn't mean for that to go so far. Can I cancel out the 6 and the 2 and get 3 over 1? The answer is no, you cannot do that. You cannot simplify just the 2. That division sign, that vinculum there, that 2 is being divided into the P and the 2L, so you can't just divide by 2. That is the answer right there. Okay? So that's how that works. So here's a really common example. Here's a formula for Fahrenheit coming from Celsius in degrees. If you ever heard, that's what this is. What's the formula for Celsius then, if you know Fahrenheit? Well, I'm going to solve for C. What's being done to C? It's being multiplied by 9/5 and then plus 32. So I'm going to subtract 32 from both sides. F minus 32 is just simply F minus 32. That doesn't simplify any further. Now, C is being multiplied by 9/5, so I need, of course, to divide by 9/5. But, of course, we don't divide by fractions. What do we do instead? We multiply by fractions. Parentheses matter here because I need to multiply by the 9/5, or 5/9 rather, by both the F and the 32. The 9's cancel out over here on the right. The 5's cancel out. And what do I get? Well, this beautiful formula for Celsius to go from when I know what Fahrenheit is. That is it, people. It's the same methods. It's just the simplification doesn't happen quite as much. All right. Have a great rest of your day and a great rest of your night for that matter. Talk to you later. Bye.